Hi, guys. So I don't know if you noticed, but the stage isn't usually like this. So tonight is Drama Vespers. And because of that, we have our tiny little drama praise band up here. And even though we have a small group, we still know what it's like to be completely surrounded by the power of God. And we know that there's no place we'd rather be than be in God's presence. So please sing with us as we sing Set on Fire.
I'd rather be, no place I'd rather be, no place I'd rather be than hearing your love, hearing your love. No place I'd rather be, no place I'd rather be, no place I'd rather be than hearing your love, hearing your love. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. No place I'd rather be, no place I'd rather be than hearing your love, hearing your love. No place I'd rather be, no place I'd rather be, no place I'd rather be than hearing your love, hearing your love.
Our next song is The Stand.
You stood before me. So what can I say? What can I do? Offer this heart, oh God, completely to you. So I walk upon salvation, your spirit alive in me, life to declare your promise, my soul now to stay.
With us.
Sorry, that would be my fault. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming tonight. Let's have a little prayer right here before we get started. Dear God, thank you so much for the opportunity to come here. It's so cool to be able to sit in this room with other people who are believers, other people who are open to hearing your voice speak. And I pray that you will speak to us tonight. Thank you, God. Amen. Just one announcement tomorrow for the students, the GCA students, at 2:30, you get to watch VeggieTales in the chapel. And I am informed that there will be fishy crackers and juice boxes as well. So, you don't want to miss that. All right. I was at a conference this past fall, and there was a musician there. His name was Tim Timmons. I don't know what his parents were thinking, but anyway, he's Tim Timmons. And he had this one song that really made me think. It was called What If I Believed? And as he was singing the song, he would like stop and was like, wait a minute, what if you really believed Christ is in you? And then he would start singing the song, and then he'd stop again. He'd be like, wait, what if you really believed? And I was like, okay, I get it. You know, you're saying this over and over again in the song. But then it got real quiet, and I was like, oh yeah, what if I believed? I say I believe in Jesus. I say I believe that God is powerful. But what if I lived my life like I believed that? What would be different? I think that a lot of my life I have spent saying some right things, saying that I believe in God, but living like there's no one there to actually help me with what's going on in my life today. Tonight we are imagining the spiritual warfare that goes on behind the scenes. It's kind of a microcosm of the great controversy, I guess. You know, we're not particularly good at this because we don't really know exactly what that looks like. You know, we know there is spiritual warfare going on, but we don't know how that actually appears. So we ask that tonight you imagine with us. And for those of you that know us on the stage, know the actors that are going to be up there, I ask that you try to take a leap in your imagination and not see those people, but see what they represent tonight. We are using our imaginations, but it's based in some fact from the Bible. We know, for instance, in Ephesians 6, verse 12, that God tells us our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the powers, against the rulers, against the authorities of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces in the heavenly realms. So the struggles we face on earth are not just between us and some other person. They have spiritual implications. There's things going on. The Bible says that Satan is roaming around like a roaring lion waiting to devour us. That's kind of scary to know that there's somebody out there trying to get you like that you can't even see. But the Bible doesn't stop there, and it tells us that God is our strong deliverer. In Ephesians 6, right where it was talking about that spiritual warfare, God tells us that we can put on his armor to defend us against these spiritual attacks. In James 4, 7, God gives us a promise. He says, if we humble ourselves and submit ourselves to God, then we can resist the devil, and what will the devil do? Flee from us. And if we come near to God, God will come near to us, because in 1 John 4, 4, the Bible tells us that he that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. So as you watch tonight and you see the spiritual battle going on, you know, please take our poor offering as a representation of what this is. And think about maybe what are the spiritual battles going on in your life? And do you really believe that Jesus is strong enough to handle those problems?
Thank you. great room? Good. I'm not late. Okay. Let's see here. Let's move this. And this. All right. That looks good. Okay, do I have everything? I have. See. Bible? Notes? Info cards? Pens? Roster. Okay. Amy, Tiffany, Kamala, Joy. Amy, Tiffany, Kamala, Joy. I've never done this before. It can't be that hard, right? Christian school, Bible study, small group of girls, it'll be fun. Talking about God, praying, female bonding, no problem. So why am I so nervous? Am I forgetting something? I have everything, but there's something. Here they come!
So then he was like, what's so special about that? So the teacher said, come over here, I'll show you.
I don't know that.
Why do you have to do this stupid group thing anyway? I can't wait to sit and listen to a meeting and be done with it.
Well, I heard I have like a guy living out. I think his name is Sam.
Hi, I'm Sam.
You're Sam?
Yes. I'm Sam.
Don't worry about it. She just thought you were a guy, a college man.
Shut up.
Oh, sorry to disappoint. I'm all you've got.
Oh, but great. Really... We get the room with the dumb picture. You know that's Jesus.
Yeah, I know. But he wasn't all white and blonde and puny, was he? That picture's all wrong. It is so gay. What? I didn't say he was. That picture just makes him look all weak and pathetic or something.
Joy, Jesus is God.
I know that. But that picture makes him look like he lost all his godness or something.
Well, actually, I'm glad you brought that up. That's what we're going to be talking about this week.
We're talking about Jesus being gay. No!
Oh, no, no. Of course not. No. We're going to be talking about who Jesus really is. So, let's sit down and get started. Well, first, here's some info cards for you guys to fill out, so I can get to know a little about you all. Here's a little about me. I'm Sam. I'm a student at Northwestern Adventist University. I'm a sophomore, and I'm studying journalism. As you know, a bunch of us NWAU students have come down here to spend our spring week of prayer, our spring break with you guys to do a small group week of prayer. But then, like, our group is going to meet every night this week, and then we're all going to come together and have some special Vespers service on Friday night at High Springs Youth Camp with, like, a foot washing and communion.
Ew.
I'm really excited to get to know you all this week. So, our topic for this week is, who is this Jesus? In other words, who was he really? What was he really like? Did anyone bring a Bible? Oh, Camilla?
It's Camilla.
Oh, sorry. Can you read Matthew 21:10, please?
Ugh.
Then Jesus entered Jerusalem, and the whole city was stirred and asked, who is this?
Thank you, Camilla. Well, this is talking about the time that Jesus went into Jerusalem riding on the donkey, and all the people were so impressed with him that they had to ask, who is this guy? So, hopefully, through this week of prayer, we will be impressed by Jesus, or at least be curious about him and have to ask, who is this guy? And hopefully get to know him a little better. So, most people, when they think about Jesus, think of him.
Oh, I can't believe how easy this is going to be. I love my job.
Yeah, what about that girl they have leading out? I hear she prays and stuff.
She's such a
All we have to do is keep these girls distracted for a few minutes each day in these small group meetings, and it's back to business as usual for the rest of the time.
And they're so easily distracted.
Yeah, that's nice and all, but what about him?
Him? Do you see anyone here giving him half a chance? Even that girl leading out hasn't asked for his help. As long as this keeps up, he's still free.
So, hopefully through this week of prayer, we'll come to know Jesus a little bit better and realize he's a lot better than this picture makes him look. All right, well, you guys can pass in those info cards and I...
I'm so glad that's over. So the rest of the week, you know.
That was a complete disaster. They were bored into comas. Oh, info cards. This should be fun. All right. Birthday. Okay. Favorite food? Pork rinds? That must be a joke. I see dead people. Great. Help? What does that mean? Oh, what am I doing here? This is gonna be a long week.
And Eva got out early.
Why couldn't I have been in a group with Grace and Eva?
You got a bunch of losers instead.
Instead, I get stuck with a bunch of losers. Well, I really shouldn't call them losers. That's not very nice.
Yeah, but really.
But really, Tiffany is such a fakey, flirty airhead. I'm so sick and tired of hearing her talk about her guys. And Joy, how could she say that about Jesus' picture? That's just rude, like sacrilegious.
And please, don't forget Amy.
And Amy is so sulky all the time. She acts so depressed and like nobody's worthy to talk to her. Her Royal Highness.
What about Sam?
Sam's pretty nice. She's a bit inexperienced, though. I bet I could help her out since I think I'm the only other Christian in the group. Real Christian, I mean. I think Tiffany's been baptized, but...
She's such a hypocrite.
Hypocrites like her are the reason people leave the church. I mean, she says she's a Christian, and then she acts like a slut with anything male. Well, I really shouldn't call her a slut. That's not very nice.
Hey, it's the truth. I mean, doesn't the Bible say you should tell the truth?
I'm only telling the truth like the Bible tells me to do.
It would be hypocritical, like Tiffany, if you didn't tell the truth.
I don't want to be a hypocrite. I say I love Jesus. And I do. I say reading the Bible is important, and I read it every day. I say we should pray for other people. So once a week, Eve and I get together and we pray for people, like for Mrs. Granger, because she's been acting so stuck up in class lately. And then just yesterday, I asked Claire to sit with me at lunch. And you know, she never gets asked to sit with anyone. How can a person let themselves smell so weird? Anyway, and we pray for people like Amy, because Eva saw her wearing short sleeves once, and there were scars on her arm. And we all know what that means. And we pray for Zoe because she used to hang out with us, but now she's acting all stuck up and won't talk to us.
We think she's backslid and fallen away from God. But see, we pray for people. I'm a real Christian, not a hypocrite.
Sure, you're a real Christian. You shouldn't even have to go to these small group meetings anyway.
There should be some kind of screening so that those of us who already know about religious stuff don't have to go to these meetings.
I mean, after all, you know all this stuff. You could probably lead out better than Sam.
Of course I've heard all this stuff before. I could probably lead out. I mean, I read through the whole Bible 2 years ago, so I mean, it's not like there's too much new stuff to hear about Jesus.
Oh, man, it's getting late.
Oh, I'm so tired.
Oh, man, you still have that algebra to finish.
Oh, I didn't finish my algebra 2 assignment.
You're
done. I've got that chemistry quiz tomorrow. Oh, okay, you know, I'm not gonna think about it right now. I'm just gonna wake up early, do it before breakfast, and then just go to bed now.
Oh, yeah. Worship. Best you get it. Guess you better get that out of the way.
I bet none of those other girls read their Bibles.
They don't. I doubt they even own a Bible.
If they even own a Bible. At least one of us should read our Bible during week of prayer. I bet Tiffany and Amy don't, and I know Joy doesn't.
People like them must make it hard for,
People like them must make it hard for Jesus. I mean, hopefully I can be a good influence here at this school for him so he doesn't have to worry about fixing everyone here.
Right. Sam sure is lucky to have you in her group.
Let's see, where am I? Revelation. All right. To the people of the church of Laodicea, I write.
Blah, blah.
These are the words of the Amen, the true and faithful witness.
So ooh. Sleepy. Ugh.
Neither
loads of
cool
homework.
Nor hot, lukewarm,
you better just fall asleep
spit you
like
out
a good
of my
little
mouth.
Christian.
Oh, do you not realize you're...
Good
oh,
little
that's
Christian.
Nice.
Why do you hide, or don't you know, I just want to be with you, to be with you. Looking down above, as you
When the people asked the man, "Who is this guy who healed you?" all the man could say was, "I don't know who he is, but I know that he healed me." All Jesus needed to do was heal some people, and that was enough for them to know that he was their healer, you know? And their faith grew from that. So, do you have any questions about this idea of Jesus as healer?
Yeah, like, why does Jesus heal people today?
Maybe he can't.
Oh, what? I'm just saying.
Anyway... My cousin just died of cancer, and it was, like, really sad for a whole family. So why didn't Jesus heal her?
Maybe your mom didn't pray hard enough.
What the heck
are you
well...
God does heal people today. There's tons of stories about people getting these weird diseases, and then they're healed, and the doctors can't explain what happened. Like my grandma.
Oh, sorry,
she got a really bad fever when she was little, and it made her go deaf. And then one day, she heard footsteps when no one was there, and after that, she could heal.
Yeah, that's great and all, but, I mean, did you ever stop to think that maybe the, oh, I don't know, the doctor's treatments were actually working?
You just have to have faith. You can make anything sound like a coincidence if you don't have some faith.
That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard. If you have faith, you can make everything sound like a miracle. My alarm clock woke me up today. It must be a miracle because of my faith. I didn't have to run a PE today. It must be because of my extra strong faith.
Could you guys just keep it down and let her answer my question?
Ugh. Yeah, I'd kind of like to hear the answer, too. Well, to answer your first question, Tiffany, when Jesus was on the earth, he was like a bridegroom, and it was a big celebration. So he healed lots of people to show God's love to them and to let them know that he could not only heal their bodies, but also forgive their sins. But now that Jesus has gone back to heaven, things are different. His power's not so visible now because our faith is in different places, and he can see the big picture we can't see. So he can't heal everyone, but he only chooses to heal some because that's what's best for us.
What?
That made no sense.
Oh, look, time to go.
That really didn't make any sense, did it? Forget it. I don't need this.
Need something quick. My mind is numb. My stomach's sick. Broken hearts. Hopeless things. I've seen what defiance brings. 'Cause the light of day I've always known is in my heart. I'm not alone. Speak to me and tell me all the things I need to know. I want to hear you now. Can you speak to me? I've opened up your world to free me. I want to hear you now.
Small groups are seriously cutting into my time.
You didn't even get to see Ryan today.
I haven't even seen Ryan today, and I wore this shirt just for Thomas.
Thomas, forget about Thomas. You practically saw no guys today.
It's like I've seen no guys at all today. Like, I need my guys. I'm like having withdrawals or something.
Cell phone.
Voicemail. What? Oh yeah, they're basketball practice. Hey Chandler, I really miss you today. Save me a seat at breakfast tomorrow. Hugs and kisses, baby. Bye.
Whoa, I guess you're all alone. You know, I find it stupid how they move rec for these week of prayer meetings.
If they had moved rec to 6 o'clock, when it had to be my stupid drama class, this would have been a problem if not for that.
It's like they're cutting out all the important stuff.
These teachers are so clueless.
It's like they don't want you to have friends or something.
We're not going to use anything they teach us anyway.
This school just doesn't get it.
Like, when are we supposed to hang out with our friends? I mean, socializing is what's really important. We're gonna have to deal with people for the rest of our lives, right? Might as well spend time with people our age.
So true. Hey, is that a zit?
Wait, is that a zit?
Ew, it's kind of gross.
Ew, it's enormous.
What is happening to you?
What's going on? This hasn't happened to me.
Maybe Jesus can heal your zit.
Help, my life is ruined by this.
Honey, acne ain't your only problem.
Wait. My ears getting bigger? I think they're sticking out.
I wasn't talking about your ears.
No, it's definitely the pants.
Girl, you have really let yourself go.
Wait a minute. Oh, wait, these shoes are like 10 pounds. Think thin. Gain 7 pounds.
know, this never would have happened last year.
This didn't happen to me last year.
You were the prettiest girl in school, you know.
I was definitely the prettiest girl in school.
But now,
what am I?
Second best, maybe.
I'm second. But who?
Carmen. Definitely Carmen.
Carmen. So
perfect.
Perfect.
But I'm sure she has some help.
You know what? She probably has like an eating disorder. And her parents are so rich, so she has all the best clothes to make her look good.
She's pretty popular too.
And she's popular because she has so much money.
And beautiful.
And she's beautiful.
And what have you got?
And I've got...
You're not so pretty anymore. And you're all alone. And you really need to be pretty or popular to have friends, you know.
I have to be beautiful.
Maybe you should try a diet.
A diet? That's all I need, you know?
Skip some meals, watch the calories, cut the carbs.
One meal a day, that's all I need.
And exercise.
And I'll just exercise more, jog farther and lift weights.
It's gonna be rough. You're gonna get hungry.
I'm already hungry just thinking about it.
But you have to make the sacrifice.
I have to be beautiful.
And you better do something about that.
What am I?
You better figure something out. Chandler will not want to sit next to you with you looking like that.
We can just cover it up.
You better. You have to be beautiful.
I have to be beautiful.
Because without your beauty then...
You're nothing.
And who could ever love a nothing?
I'm nothing.
That's always so easy.
So good to see you all today. Do you have any prayer requests today? No? All right. We'll just pray then. Dear Jesus, thank you for this opportunity to learn more about you and help us to have a good time together today. Amen. So last time we looked at how Jesus was our healer. Today we're talking about how Jesus is our Lord.
Oh, joy.
What does it mean to be a Lord?
Like a king or something?
Yes, Amy, thanks. A king or a ruler, a master. A Lord is someone greater than us.
higher than us, above us. The people around Jesus understood this. I don't know if it was something in his eye or his voice or just his presence, but the people around Jesus understood that he was their Lord. Let's look at a few examples. Oh. Look in Luke chapter 5. Here we see a man with leprosy come to Jesus. And he runs to him and says, "Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean." This man knew that Jesus was Lord and King and could heal him. He only needed to know if Jesus was willing. And of course, Jesus healed him. But even those who know that Jesus is their Lord have to be careful. When Peter saw Jesus filling the fishermen's nets with fish, he called Jesus his Lord. And in Matthew 16, Peter called Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God. And later, he promised he would be faithful to Jesus. He would even die for him, even if no one else did. But just a few verses later, when Jesus was arrested and in danger, Peter denied knowing Jesus at all. He even said, "I don't know that man at all." See, Peter forgot that Jesus is our Lord. And we still forget that today. Jesus is our Lord. We are his people. We must not forget our place in relation to Jesus. We must follow where he leads and do as he says. We have no right to do things our own way or pretend our ideas are better than God's.
So I guess you're just a slave then.
So what? We have no say in anything then? Like a slave or something?
This is so stupid.
Joy, Jesus loves us, so obviously he's going to lead us to do things that are good for us.
Ugh.
Whatever.
Can you guys just stop so she can finish and we can get out of here?
Yeah, so you can go make out with your boyfriends, right?
Shut up! Those guys are my friends.
Friends with benefits, hmm? Everybody gets what they want.
Shut up! They're not like that.
Oh, not them. You.
What do you mean?
I mean, you just use those guys the way you want. You don't really like any of them. You just want to be popular. What better way to do that than half the guys on campus hanging off you all the time? Tell me, I'm curious. What do you do for them to get them to look at you like that?
Oh,
you
little...
Hit a nerve, did I? Truth hurts, doesn't it?
Well, I guess I shouldn't be too surprised that you're talking to me like this. I mean, poor Joy. Her mom couldn't even live long enough to teach her how to shut her mouth.
Want to bring mothers into this? Fine with me. Let's talk about what your mother does for a living. But maybe we shouldn't. Like mother, like daughter, as they say.
Do not talk to me!
You just can't take it! Now I'm telling you like it is! I am not going to be fake with you! So if you can't take it, just shut your mouth! Stop it!
Maybe we should.
This has been so inspiring, but oh look, it's time to go.
Tiffany.
Shut up!
Really, God? I can use some help here. Why haven't you helped me?
You do not have because you do not ask.
What? I haven't asked?
Is any of you in trouble? He should pray.
I haven't been praying to ask for God's help.
If any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to him. This is the confidence you have in approaching your Savior, that if you ask anything according to his will, I will hear you. For everyone who asks receives.
I'm sorry, Jesus, for trying to do this on my own. I obviously don't know what I'm doing here. I don't think they've heard a thing I've said. And if they have heard and asked a question, I couldn't give an answer that made any sense. We're having fights instead of Bible studies. I know you love these girls. but I'm failing miserably.
I love those girls more than you could ever know. I will reach them. I'm not intimidated by their problems. Your God is a consuming fire.
I'm sorry, Jesus. I forgot how powerful you are.
And as for you, my grace is enough for you. For my power is made perfect in your weakness. When you are weak, I am strong.
Lord, please be strong in me, in all of us.
Man, everybody's fighting. Fighting at home, fighting in the dorm, another even fighting in Bible study.
I hate fighting. Why can't people just be nice?
You have enough to deal with as it is.
It's just, everything's too much.
School stuff, people stuff, family stuff, and other stuff.
Too much.
Grade reports come out next week.
Oh, Mom and Dad are going to kill me when they see my chemistry grade. And my English grade. Is it humanly possible to write a research paper?
It's not like you are your brother.
It's not like I'm Carson, Mr. 4.0, popular basketball star, good looking. I'm just me. What do they expect?
It's not like you're ever gonna be really good at stuff like he was.
I'm not good at anything.
That's what your dad says anyway.
Nothing I do is good enough for him.
You're just not good enough.
I'm just not good.
Speaking of Mom and Dad,
no, I don't want to think about that.
What was their problem anyway?
No!
They were acting so stupid.
Oh, why can't my parents be parents? Why can't they just be adults?
They're like bratty kids, fighting all the time.
They're like bratty kindergartners fighting all the time. Why can't I be a kid? Why do I have to be the adult? 7 years old, holding my own mom as she cries after another fight, and Dad going out to his hole in the garage or wherever he went.
Some childhood. I bet nobody else's parents to fight over everything the way yours do.
No one else's parents fight over everything like mine do.
Money, groceries.
Who gets to spend the money? Who goes to the store? Who cleans the dog? Where should we go to church? Should we go to church? Who goes to Carson's basketball games?
And you.
And me.
Maybe that's the real problem.
I'm the real problem. What to do about Amy? It's your fault. No, it's yours. Well, where were you when she almost died? Well, where were you when she was in the hospital?
And what do we do with her now?
What should we do with our problem child now? Let's stick her in rehab. No, it's too expensive. Well, she needs help. No, she needs to suck it up and deal with life. Well, she can't stay here. We can't deal with that.
That's one thing they agreed on.
They actually agreed on that.
That's probably why they're separating. They just can't deal with you.
It's all my fault. I'm just not good.
Why couldn't you have been a good daughter?
Not good enough.
Well, if you're not good enough for your parents, how will you ever be good enough for God?
Well, Sam said...
Sam? What would she know? That Jesus loves you quite is great for church people. Good little girls and boys who've never had any real problems like you.
I don't do that anymore.
Oh, really? Then when did that happen?
It was just,
I don't see why everybody makes such a big deal about it. It's not like you're running around slashing other people.
I don't want to do that anymore.
Yeah,
there are better ways to...
Psycho babble. Everybody freaks out and sticks you in therapy when they realize what's going on. But really, if it helps you deal with your crummy life...
It would just be a little...
Sure, you're not going to mess up a man at the hospital or anything. You've got control now.
I know what I'm doing.
You control it. You can hide it. It's not going to bother anyone.
No one will know.
Nobody cares enough to look anyway.
I need to get some of it out. Some of the pressure. Some of the...
Evil?
Some of the bad in me. Maybe then I'll be good enough for them.
Sure. You can hide it. You can control it. It's not like you're addicted or anything.
Addicted?
Remember how good it felt? Just let all that evil drain out of you.
But it's not right.
Hey, don't you still have a stash lying around here? I know I saw some last week.
Just one more time?
One more time.
It's been a really bad week.
You've been really bad this week.
Came, stole my mind, wrapped my soul in chains. Now I live among the dead, fighting voices in my head, hoping someone hears me crying in the night and carries me away. Set me free.
Let's get started with prayer. Dear Jesus, please come close to us today and help us. Amen.
Hey, where's that picture of Jesus?
I took it down.
Why?
Joe was right. That picture didn't give us a good idea of who Jesus really was. I guess I should thank you, Joy. I didn't like that when you said that about the picture, but when I thought about why it bothered me so much, I realized that people, including myself, often act as if Jesus is weak and ineffective in our real lives. We may like Jesus, we may pray to him, we may even believe all the Bible stories about all the miracles he did, but when it comes to believing in our own real lives, we don't think he has any practical power to help us. But the Jesus we read about in the Bible is still the same Jesus today. And let's not forget, Jesus is God, almighty, all-powerful God. With just a few words or a touch, Jesus cured diseases and injuries. With just a few words, Jesus brought people back from the dead. With just a few words, he made a violent storm. Stop! Just like that. With just a few words, Jesus commanded that demons release the people they had possessed, and the demons fled, screaming in terror. If Jesus, our God, can do all of that,
barely lift a hand or speak a sentence, imagine the power he still holds inside. And imagine the power he can have in our lives today. Power to help us when we're hurting, or lonely, or disappointed, or broken.
Powerful? Look at him, day after day, sulking in the background like he's helpless and mute. He doesn't look so powerful to me.
Just looking at you.
So? He has no power here. This is our territory. They have to choose to listen to him.
I know. But
he's what? Powerful? Almighty God? Yes, maybe so. But he makes the rules, and he has to keep them. He lets them choose, and they choose us. Time after time, they choose us. Look at these girls. We own them. She's sitting there thinking she knows all of this stuff, so she's not even paying attention. And she is so desperate for outer beauty and attention that she's not even listening to his puny little still small voice.
Can't even see it now, honey. You're so hot.
She's so far down in the hole of self-pity and self-destruction that she wouldn't see you if you parted the Red Sea in her face.
You're just not good enough.
And she is so full of anger, rage, and hate, she's ready to throw her broken heart in your face. Powerful? No. Pathetic. We've defeated you.
Even when Jesus died on the cross, he wasn't defeated or powerless. He was victorious. And one day, we will see our God face to face and understand just how powerful he is. The Bible says Jesus will come on the clouds of the sky with power and great glory. Jesus says,
Behold,
I am coming soon.
My reward is with me,
and I will give to everyone according to what he has done.
I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end.
And then Jesus will wipe every tear from our eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain,
for the old order of things has passed away.
That is no defeated God. That is Jesus, our God, our awesome, powerful God.
I just told the truth, and she knows it. So does everyone else. What are they?
Fortunately, you only have two more days with that group.
I'm not even sure Jesus would want to be in the same room as those girls. Well, I guess because he loves everybody and stuff. only two more days of Tiffany.
And Camilla.
Miss, I'm such a good little Christian, and all you guys suck.
Jerk.
What a jerk. Dang it, where are they?
You know, you could sneak your phone to that Vespers foot washing thing tomorrow night. You know, skip out.
Ugh, if I find my headphones, I'll sneak my phone into that disgusting Vespers feet thing. Ugh, there'll be a lot of people there. I'm sure no one will notice. Where are they?
I bet somebody stole them.
If somebody came in here and...
Why did they make you do all this religious junk anyway?
Ugh, we have like 50 week of prayers every year.
And teachers still give homework, you know.
Teachers act like it's a regular week. I have a pre-cal quiz tomorrow.
They should just let you study.
That's what I need to do. Study and do my homework so I can graduate already and get out of this dump. Hopefully college is better because I cannot spend 4 more years of my life in this.
Ugh. Yeah, that's your real life. What does this week of prayer stuff have to do with that?
Look, it's not like I have a problem with Jesus, but there's real life and there's religious life, right?
Healer? Powerful God? What does any of that have to do with what you're actually going through?
Has Sam actually said anything that can help me?
Does it mean anything anyway?
Ugh. Just saying that Jesus is powerful God doesn't really mean anything. Do I see him doing powerful stuff in my life? No. Has he ever? No.
He's had plenty of chances to step in and help you.
Sure have been times he could have helped me.
Seems like he could have kept your mom alive.
Would have been nice to have a mother. Jesus could have healed her so I didn't have to watch her die slowly.
And your brothers were so young.
Did God even care that mom had 1-year-old twins who needed her?
Could have at least helped your dad. It left him a broken man.
That's never been the same since mom died. It's like he needed someone to help him. So I did. I got the groceries, I took care of the twins, I got myself to school and back.
Still wasn't enough for him.
I couldn't do enough to help him.
Enter the stepmother.
Oh, and now I have the wicked stepmother. I hope you can learn to love me like a mother. Ugh.
And that brother of hers, that very nice man.
Jesus could have kept that creep away from me.
He was always so sweet to you with that gentle voice.
Stop! Now I really need my headphones. I have to get that voice out of my head. Ugh.
Some help Sam's powerful Jesus was.
Of all the times in my stupid life when God could have stepped in and helped me, did he ever? No. Right. Jesus loves the little children. But where was he for me when I got hurt? Any of the times that I got hurt. If he was there, he was either too weak to help me or he just didn't care. Oh, I don't need a God like that.
You don't need a God. Especially one who has no power to help you.
I will get through this. I'll work hard. I'll be better than all those stupid people at school. My life will be better. I don't need anyone!
Especially a useless Jesus who has no power.
Look, I want to believe in Jesus, but I just don't see him anywhere. Hello! Is anybody out there? Oh, I'd have to do something really major, like appear right in front of me, or...
Alter the laws of physics?
Alter the laws of physics, or...
Take revenge on all the evil people.
Give all the evil perverts what they deserve, or... Change me.
No! The earbuds! Where are your earbuds?
Where are my headphones? Oh.
Look, you had to spend all your time cleaning your room so you could find your stupid earbuds, and it's all because of this stupid week of prayer.
Ugh, 5 minutes to light up. Great, that's what this stupid week of prayer gave me. Why do we all need to go? I shouldn't have to go. I'm fine. Most of us are fine. It's not like all of us are hurting and broken and lonely and angry and disappointed and... Oh my God.
We're not finished here. She's still mine.
Just how far we have to fall. And I am not immune. I only want to be loved. But I feel safe behind the firewall. Can I lose my need to impress? If you want the truth, need to confess that I'm not alright. I'm broken inside, broken inside. And all I go through, it leads me to you. Honest.
there yet?
I think we have about half an hour to go.
Ugh. Are we gonna be late? I don't wanna miss the communion service.
Yeah, I don't wanna miss my friends.
We wouldn't be late if we'd have to wait 15 minutes for you to finish curling your eyelash or whatever it is you do to get beautiful.
At least I care about how I look.
We might miss the first part of song service, but other than that, I think we're gonna be okay.
Oh, Tiffany, you made Camilla miss the beautiful song service. Now she can't hear, Lord, I lift your name on high.
Oh, like your music is so much better. Hey, someone is screaming and smashing a trash can. That's not music. It sounds like an animal's being tortured and killed.
Oh, but that's what I hear when you speak to me, Camilla.
What do you read it anyway?
Love's Echoing Call. Ooh, romance novel. Any juicy scenes?
It's not a romance novel, it's a Christian book.
Ooh, veggie romance, even better.
Could you just keep it down a bit? I'm still on the phone and you're gonna make Amy cry again.
All right, girls, I know you're not the best of friends, but can you please try to get along just for tonight? Please? God, we really need your help.
Are we there?
No, the car stalled?
No, the car can't stop. I don't have the reception here.
Hold on, let me try again.
Okay. Are we
out of
gas?
Sam, are we gonna die? Sam, I can't die here. Sam,
I can't miss the communion service?
Sam,
that's
Sam,
the best
Sam,
part
Sam.
Of the church.
All right. I have a friend who knows a lot about cars. I'll give him a call. Just hold on a second.
You do that.
I don't like this. He had something to do with this, didn't he?
There's nothing wrong with that car, is there?
Okay, she braked. I saw it. Then he messed with the engine or something.
What would he do that for?
I don't know.
Whatever he is, he's no fool. He has a reason.
This is making me nervous.
It should. He thinks he has us trapped here.
Trapped?
But they're not listening. They're distracted.
For now. Who knows what else he has up his holy sleeves. That girl's prayers are working, and we can't touch her right now.
We only have the girls as long as we can keep them distracted.
See, we have the reader. The book, with the reader, and the cell phone, and the sleeper. These girls are putty in our hands.
Guys, can't you feel it? The power?
Yeah, well, maybe so, but they still have to choose to listen to them. He's not gonna force them.
Besides, we have till they get a ride to Vespers. How long could that take?
I hope you're right.
Sam, what do you say, Sam? I'm not dying here with you, right?
Are we
gonna live, Sam? Are we gonna miss it?
Talk to my friend who knows a lot about cars.
And
he said that there's something wrong with the something.
Ugh.
All I know is it's nothing we can fix right now. And he's probably gonna take about half an hour to get here.
Great, we're gonna miss the whole thing.
Well, at least something good came out of this.
Now I had to call Thomas so he won't say me a seat.
Ew.
Wait, no, there's no service here. Sam, didn't you make a call?
Yeah, but mine cut out at the end too.
Wait, no, how is this dead? I swear, no! Ugh.
This really sucks.
At least you still have your book.
No, I finished it as the car broke down.
So what are we supposed to do now, Sam? We're in the middle of nowhere and now we have nothing to do!
And now Amy's awake too.
Ugh.
Can't
read
going on.
Great.
What is it, Sam? Come on.
I think we should have a Vesper service of our own.
Why?
We're in a broken down car in the middle of the street in the dark.
I don't believe God will only meet us if we're in a church. I think he's here with us right now. All right. So, I know I'm not really good at this, and most of what I say doesn't make any sense, and you guys are bored and frustrated. Oh, what am I trying to say?
That's a good question.
All right.
Don't worry. how you will defend yourself, what you will say. For the Holy Spirit will teach you at the time what you should say.
Our theme for this week was, who is this Jesus? In other words, who is he really? What is he really like? Okay, so I don't know if you've heard anything else I've said all week, but this is the most important part, okay? Jesus is our Savior. Jesus is our Savior, don't you see? Oh, God, give me the right words. Okay. Jesus is our Savior because he saved us from our sins. We ought to die because of our sins, but Jesus died instead on the cross in our place. That makes him our Savior. But if that's all he did, what does that have to do with our lives today? That has everything to do with our lives today. Our problems, our pain, our disappointment, our loneliness, our whatever. Okay? Jesus isn't scared of your problems. He's not intimidated by your issues. He's not afraid of things going on in your life. And he doesn't believe the lies that Satan whispers into your head. The Bible says that Jesus is a strong deliverer. He's a warrior. He's strong. He's powerful. He sees the things that are going on in your life, and he can handle it. He sees the problems. He sees the pain. He sees the loneliness. He sees what makes you feel happy or sad or angry or ugly or what makes you feel like giving up. He sees all of that, and he can handle it. He cares. He loves you. You! Bad things happen. You get hurt. I don't know why. Sometimes it feels like evil has won and God has been defeated. But Jesus is never defeated. He fights for us to save us. He's our strong, undefeated champion. And one day, he'll fight the last fight, and it will all be over. Sin, evil, pain, tears will all be over. Jesus will make it right. And until then, he holds us. He is strong enough for us. Hey, Jesus brought himself back from the dead, right? If he's powerful enough to do that, don't you think he's powerful enough to bring your broken, battered, selfish, guilty heart back to life? Beauty from ashes. Fire from where you've been dead cold. Hope out of nightmares. Peace instead of guilt. That is power. A powerful Savior. And he's just waiting to be powerful for you. That's all right. We might even make it for the last part of Vespers.
They tell you where you need to go. They tell you when you need to leave. They tell you what you need to know. Tell you who you need to be. Everything inside you knows there's more than what you've heard. There's so much more than empty conversations filled with empty words. You're on fire when the knee is near you. You're on fire when he speaks.
know they need me.
But your struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms.
The powers of this dark world? Those girls don't even know that Satan is pounding them to death. Jesus, please fight for them.
Come on, relax. You've got nothing to worry about. Don't let someone make you feel guilty for nothing. You don't need all that repentance, Jesus can fight for you stuff. You aren't a sinner. You're a good Christian. You've got it all under control. You read the Bible. You've gone to church all of your life. You're nice to other people. You pray. Take a break. Relax. Read a good book. Go talk to your friends. You deserve it. You deserve the rest. Anyway, the Bible will still be here for you when you get back. Jesus will still be here for you, right? He'll always be here. You don't have to be in a hurry. You're doing just fine.
I probably shouldn't worry about it. I'm just feeling guilty for nothing. But I wonder, even now, do I really know who Jesus is? Have I really experienced him? Maybe I'm not just blind. Maybe I really do need help. Maybe my heart does need to be healed. Maybe.
What's the point? You never want to be beautiful anyway.
Never in the world.
You had so nice clothes and wore a lot of makeup. That doesn't make you beautiful. You can try, but you'll never be able to keep up. Do you really think you'll be the right size in all the right places? The right hair, the right clothes, the right complexion? You don't have that much money, and you don't have that much raw material to start with. Basically, you can try and try and try all of your life, but you will never be ready for just okay. So what's the point? You know, don't you? Because if you stop trying to be beautiful, you'll be ugly. You can't live like that. If you're ugly, you're nothing. You're nobody. No one will love you. Your life is worthless unless you're beautiful.
I'll never look like that.
What's the point? I'll never be beautiful. Try and try and try, but nothing. Nothing works.
I'm just not.
Can't live like this. I'm nothing. I'm nobody.
Jesus, he really loves me. Doesn't that make me somebody? Maybe he thinks I'm beautiful. Maybe.
Such a disappointment. They had such high hopes for you to be successful as your brother. But obviously, you're not really good at anything. You get bad grades, you're ugly, you have no friends. People don't like you. Why should they? Your own parents don't even love you. You don't even like yourself. You contribute nothing to society. How do I know that? Simple. How would people miss you if you were dead? I can't think of any candy. I don't even know why you just couldn't cut yourself. A hideous person like you must have poison in your veins. Go ahead, open it up, and I'll let the demon pour out. Yeah, let it all pour out. As a cutter, there's always going to be somebody's unwelcome problem. But as a corpse, well, you'd be out of everyone's way to kill. Go ahead and do it.
Not good enough. Never good enough. No one likes me. My own family hates me.
the evil me pour out. But what if there was one who loved me? What if his love could cure the evil? Would that be worth living for? Would love be worth living for?
Thank you. Hey guys, welcome in.
Thanks, Sam, I'm glad we talked.
Yeah,
me too. I think you're gonna be just fine. You're doing the right thing.
This is our last meeting, isn't it?
Yes. We come together here for Sabbath school, and then we all come together for church, and then we have lunch in some Saturday afternoon thing.
Too bad, I was just starting to get used to you people.
Do you really mean that?
Don't read too much into it. I'm not gonna sit with you at lunch every day or come to your room to paint my nails and talk about the cute boys. I didn't mean anything by that, sorry.
It's okay, I was just gonna use your annoying personality myself.
I know, I'm an acquired taste.
Well, let's pray to get started. Dear Jesus, please come close to us today and help us to know your power in our lives. Amen. Well, at the end of these things, we're supposed to talk about what we learned, like how we changed, kind of debrief. But first, I want to show you something.
Hey, you got a new picture.
Yeah, it kind of symbolizes what we've been talking about this week. Tell me what you think.
What on earth? Whoa.
That's Jesus?
He's buff.
He's boxing. Yeah, I'm not sure this picture is any more accurate than the other one as far as how Jesus looked.
Yeah, he's still a little bit blonde.
Yeah, but he sure isn't puny here.
Look, his gloves say mercy on them.
Yeah, like, he fights with mercy. His mercy is strong enough to defend against all comers. That's kind of weird.
Yeah, my first reaction when I saw it was, is it okay to show Jesus like that?
Yeah, isn't that, like, sacrilegious?
Well, you said Jesus was powerful, right?
Exactly. I'm not sure this picture's any more accurate as far as how Jesus really looked.
Yeah, he probably never wore boxing gloves.
Yeah, but wait, he did fight for us, right? Like, when he died on the cross, look, there's a scar on his side.
Exactly, and he still fights for us today. So, let's talk about how we saw Jesus fighting for us this week. How did you see God's power working in your lives? Would anyone like to share?
Jesus helped me with a bad habit I have. I don't think it magically went away, but I think he showed me that he's going to fight it for me, and that's really nice to know.
I have something.
Yeah.
Well, this is going to sound really weird, but I've had this problem with you, like self-esteem or something, and it's like these voices inside my head, well, not really like that, but it's like they tell me and point out every little thing that's wrong with me, and it gets me really depressed. But it was like Jesus told them to shut up, and they did. And that's power to me.
I guess I'll go next. I don't really know how to say it, but Jesus seems more real to me now. I mean, you all know I'm not the nicest person in the world. I know that. I mean, I know people hate me most of the time, and most of the time, I hate other people. But there's something, I don't know, now I know that Jesus doesn't hate me. And somehow that makes a big difference. Oh, I don't know how to say it.
That's okay. I think we understand.
I like the picture. I'll always imagine Jesus beating the crud out of my problems now. I think he is strong enough.
Camilla, you have anything to share? You don't have to.
I don't know, it's fine. I know that Jesus is my best friend, and that if I have a problem, I can tell him. And I know that after the week of prayer and all the spiritual high of the week fades and everything goes back to being just the same as it was before, that, you know, he'll still be there.
That's kind of depressing.
Yeah.
What? You all know it's true. You may feel all spiritual right now, but after it's over, you're the same.
Wow. I don't think I'll ever be the same.
Well, let's take that as our challenge. Let's try to remember God's power in our lives. I mean, even after the spiritual high is gone. Trusting Jesus is a choice anyway, not a feeling. Let's pray one more time. I think it's almost time to go.
Yep, we're doing the healing thing, okay?
Dear Jesus.
It's over.
You are such an awesome God.
You're not giving up yet.
Our strong, undefeated champion.
I think I've still got a chance.
We thank you for being powerful in our lives.
normal next week.
And in your holy name, we pray that you'll come into our heart.
Hold your ground!
And drive out every stronghold of Satan. Wash us clean and make us new.
Not giving up.
We don't want to go back to the way we were.
We watch for weakness.
We know that we're in a spiritual fight against evil.
Like a roaring lion.
We also know we can't win these spiritual battles on our own. Jesus, be our champion.
Never give up!
And fight for us!
Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Come near to me, and I will come near to you. Be strong in me and in my power. Put on the full armor of God so you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. But do not be afraid of them, for I myself will fight for you. For in this world, you will have trouble. Have courage. I have defeated the world. And I will be with you, always, to the end of the age.
Amen.
Prayer for this evening. And now we'd like to invite any of you who would feel like you would like to come up and pray. You do that now. Otherwise, you guys are dismissed. Thank you so much for being with us tonight.